What's up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter and Instagram followers? It's your boy No Name back at it again with another New York Giants video. And before we get into the topic for today, I just want to say make sure you guys tune in tonight to the Young Guns podcast. Of course, since last week it was on my channel and we flip-flop every week, this week it is going to be on Kid Blue's channel. Usually it's held on Tuesdays, but we have to shift it over today just for time concerns because we'll be having a special guest on. I think most of you already know who it is. I've announced it on Twitter and community notes, as have Kid Blue. Our special guest will be the 2020 undrafted free agent for the New York Giants, the linebacker Oluwole Batiku, out of Illinois, I believe. He will be coming on to the podcast. Yes, we're having an actual Giants player on the podcast. I hope you guys tune in. Myself and Kid Blue, we've come up with our own couple of questions, but there will be a Q&A section towards the end. I really hope you guys tune in, you know, share the stream everywhere, get as much people as you can in there, because we'll be having a Giants player on. And of course, a huge shout out to Jesse Bryan. He, a subscriber of mine and Kid Blue, that connected us with Oluwole. So for sure, huge shout out to Jesse. Without him, it wouldn't be possible. Make sure you tune in tonight at 9 p.m. Now on to the topic at hand today. We are talking about, of course, since it is July 15th, it is the, you know, the deadline of the franchise tag, so to speak. Today, July 15th at 4 p.m. is the last day and the last time teams will have to negotiate a long-term contracts with players that they have on the franchise tag. Otherwise, they'll, you know, continue to play on that franchise tag moving into the season. And as of right now, as of 1:52 p.m. on July 15th, that's when I'm recording this, Leonard Williams has not gotten an extension. Now, that's no surprise by Giants fans or anybody really looking at, from outside, looking into the situation. Leonard Williams didn't seem like he was going to get an extension from the Giants. And I think we all agree it wasn't exactly the smartest move to tag this guy. Now, of course, we all know the story. He's on the defensive tackle franchise tag because he played more snaps at defensive tackle than at defensive end the past year. And of course, being a defensive end in a 3-4 system, you're technically still an interior defensive lineman because you're not lining up against an offensive tackle. Defensive tackles line up against, you know, the inside offensive lineman, and defensive end lines up against the offensive tackles. It's really just a game of semantics and wordplay when you come to think of it. But Leonard Williams is definitely a defensive tackle, so he's on that. He wants to be on the defensive end franchise tag, and he wants a contract at around $18 million a year from not really the Giants, but from anybody. He's seeking that bag. And I think we could all agree that Williams is not worth that bag. He's brought in as somebody that's supposed to be a pass rushing defensive tackle. Now, he is good in the run, and the Giants defense, their run defense, did improve when he got here. They went from 22nd in the league in run defense to 20th in the league. It's a very minor improvement, but I guess it did improve. But that's not the reason he was brought here. I definitely get people talking to me, people bring up the point saying because he's a defensive tackle, he's not supposed to get pressure on the QB, he's not supposed to get sacks. But that is exactly what Williams was brought in here for, and that's exactly what, you know, he kind of builds his game on, even though he's not really good on it or good at it. Leonard Williams, both as said by himself and by coaches that coach him, and really just the way he plays, he's supposed to be a pass rushing defensive tackle. He's supposed to be somebody like a Chris Jones, who, until he was signed by the Chiefs, I was praying somehow, some way, by a miracle of God, we traded Leonard Williams for Chris Jones or something. Now, Chris Jones is somebody that is a pass rushing defensive tackle. The dude has, 9 sacks last year and a 15.5 sacks the year before as a pass rusher from the inside of the defensive line, which is something that Williams can hope he could be one day. That's so many sacks in just the past 2 years. Williams only has around 24.5 sacks in all of his 5 years in the NFL. Once again, this is what he was built on, even coming out of college, coming out of USC, not as a run-stuffing defensive tackle. If he was, he wouldn't have been drafted as high as he was, but as a pass-rushing defensive tackle. And he's quite honestly failed to do that. You talk about half a sack last season and whatnot. So right away, it's like, I think, once again, we all know he's not exactly worth that $18 million a year type of contract. I'm not paying $18 million a year to somebody that is more of a run stuffer than they are a pass rusher. And I'm also like, the tag alone, I'm not paying 16.1 or 16.25 or something like that, $1 million for 1 year, you know, fully guaranteed to somebody that is a run stuffing defensive tackle. He really isn't that much of an upgrade over BJ Hill, which is the guy that he replaced when he came in here. And of course, like I said, we don't expect there to be an extension or anything, but it is the day of that this is supposed to happen. And it is the NFL. Who knows what could happen? There's still a chance. It's possible, but definitely improbable that Williams could be traded in, you know, one of those tag and trade situations, or even that he gets an extension from the Giants. Definitely not probable, but still possible. But as of right now, no matter what happens, Williams has kind of won this battle, so to speak. He's going to get $16 million fully guaranteed, or he's going to get an extension, or he ends up with a team that would, you know, even pay him better than the Giants do. All in all, definitely a mistake from Gettleman's part. And, you know, it's not something I like to bring up because it's a bunch of what-ifs situations going back in the past, and it's like, most of the time I don't like addressing what-ifs because what has happened has already happened. But it definitely makes me think about what could have happened if we didn't tag Williams and we would have, I don't know, just a bit more money, a bit more space in the cap room, or if we didn't even trade for Williams and we still had that third round pick, which is going even back farther. But it's not really good to dwell on those things. But that brings us to the whole situation. Why did we even tag him in the first place? Why did Gettleman place a tag on him? Because he's hoping to get some type of compensation for when Williams walk. Gettleman, I think, kind of realized his mistake in trading for him and didn't just want him to walk away. And he probably believed that there wouldn't be a trade partner available. But by tagging Williams and by having him on the roster for one more year, when he eventually does leave the Giants, and I do think that he'll leave probably at the end of or this time next year, in next year's offseason, the Giants will be awarded with a compensatory pick. Now, I don't think we're going to get a third round pick because I don't know if anybody's going to pay Williams top dollar or anything, but it's going to be somewhere between the third and seventh rounds in the 2022 draft, which is, you know, still like 2 years away from now, but it's better than nothing. And I guess that is what Gettleman was thinking about. You know, you talk about these tags and whatnot to get comp picks back. You compare it to his much smarter move with Marcus Golden, for example, where he plays that tender on him. And Golden, you know, we all know the story. His guy, his day is going to come up in July 22nd. And when it gets there, I'm going to talk more about it. But with Golden, if he did walk and he did sign with another team, the Giants were going to get a pick back. But he's going to come back to a Giants for a way cheaper contract. So I guess Gettleman was trying to do something similar here with Williams. But that's about it for the whole Leonard Williams, you know, and tag fiasco. That this point of the story is really coming to a close for the offseason, in my opinion. Whatever is going to happen is going to happen today. And the one other thing I want to talk about today was the fact that Evan Engram was ranked by NFL executives, players, and coaches as the seventh best tight end in the entire NFL, which surprised me for sure because the talent is there for him to be top 10. But the reason that I, even myself, a Giants fan, and I am an Evan Engram fan, I love the dude, would love for him to stay on the field and whatnot, but because he can't actually stay on the field, I was very surprised that this list, not selected by the media experts or, you know, guys that are, you know, talking heads on TV, whatnot, guys like me, you know, couch coaches and couch GMs, it was selected by people in the NFL, executives, players, and coaches, and this is from ESPN, that he was selected as the seventh best tight end. This is a quote from one offensive coordinator. He said, "Those who haven't watched that dude need to. He's a true receiver, polished, releases whole route tree, run after the catch. He just plays in a bad offense." Of course, referring to the offense that was last year. "Routes, breaks, he's top three." One veteran assistant coach out of the 25-year-old, but he's not really a tight end, which is definitely something that several Giants fans have brought up. A lot of us do think he is a tight end. He's just really good at the receiving part of being a tight end and should be better at the blocking part, but he's not a wide receiver either. But I do get what that offensive coordinator was saying there. And this really, it really just makes you think about what the Giants could have if this guy could stay healthy on the field. I've been saying for a couple months now, I want to say since probably March or April, that I strongly do believe the Giants offense has the potential to be top 10. If everything breaks right, that is saying that Evan Engram stays on the field more often than not. The offensive line clicks relatively early on and we have good protection for Daniel Jones and nice running lanes for Saquon Barkley and whatnot. If all of that happens, then we're going to be top 10 in my opinion. I wholly believe that. Even if it doesn't happen, I still wholly believe we're going to be a top 15 offense in the league just because we're kind of, I don't want to say we're stacked, but we're a lot more well prepared than any other team in the league when it comes to personnel, at least with the starting, you know, I want to say the starting five or whatnot. We're a lot better prepared when it comes to weapons. You talk about our starting three wide receivers in Slayton, Shepard, and Tate, a lot better than a lot of these NFL teams in here. and with specifically Slayton and then Evan Engram as a starting tight end, with those two guys in the Jason Garrett offense that uses a lot of deep passes and requires a deep threat wide receiver and of course utilizes the tight end heavily, they're going to benefit from that a lot. And with Shepard and Tate, they're going to take maybe a step back, but because they're not going to be up against number two and three corners, they're going to take advantage of that. I wholly believe they might explode a little bit despite expectations. And then, of course, you talk about Saquon Barkley, one of the best running backs in the league, if not the best running back on the ground through the year, whatever you want to argue with it. The five offensive weapons, that starting five, the depth is kind of a problem for the wide receivers, but the starting five alone can propel this team to a top 15 offense. And I really think we're super prepared on that side of the ball. And the fact that NFL execs think the same, at least with Evan Engram, if he can stay onto the field, man, it's going to do such great things for the Giants. But that's really all I got to talk about today. Kind of two topics in one, not much going on, as you guys well know. Make sure you tune in tonight for the Young Guns podcast once again. Come in and see us interview the exclusive interview with Oluwole Betiku. And that's it for now. I'm out. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'll catch y'all in the next one.